In today's tutorial, I will show you how to crochet this very very cute toadstool or a mushroom amigurumi, and it is really really easy. You can use this as a key ring or just a toy. Hi, I'm Shobori from hookedinloops.com. I make various kind of crafts tutorials in my channel, so please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon, and don't forget to like, share and comment. In this project, we will require a 4-ply acrylic yarn and a crochet hook of size 3 mm. So at first, we are making a magic circle. We will insert the hook below the first loop and draw the second loop from below. Yarn over and draw the yarn through the loop, and the magic circle is ready. You will get a better tutorial on making the magic circle from my beginner's course. Just check the playlist. And now we will begin the first round. So in the magic circle, we will be doing a total of 6 single crochet stitches. We will quickly do the 6 single crochet stitches and then pull the tail of the magic circle and close the circle. And now we will begin the second round. We will do 1 single crochet stitch in the first single crochet stitch of the last round in this manner, and we will mark this first single crochet stitch of the second round with a stitch marker in this manner. Insert the hook in the loop and continue doing this round. In the next stitch, we will be doing 2 single crochet stitches or an increase. Okay, so in the second stitch, we are doing 2 single crochet stitches. Then again in the next stitch, we will do 1 single crochet stitch, and in the following stitch, we will be doing an increase or 2 single crochet stitches, and we will repeat this pattern, that is 1 single crochet followed by 2 single crochet. At the end of the second round, take out the stitch marker. We will do the first single crochet stitch of the third round in the first single crochet stitch of the second round, and mark this first stitch with a stitch marker. Okay, in the next stitch, we will be doing 1 single crochet stitch, and in the following stitch, we will be doing 2 single crochet stitches. So the pattern is 1 single crochet followed by 1 single crochet followed by 2 single crochets, and repeat. We will now begin the fourth round. So we will do 1 single crochet stitch and mark the first single crochet stitch of the fourth round with a stitch marker. Then in the next 2 stitches, we will be doing 1 single crochet in each one of those, and in the following stitch, we will be doing an increase or 2 single crochet stitches. And we will repeat this pattern, that is 1 single crochet, 1 single crochet, 1 single crochet and 2 single crochets. Okay, we will now begin the fifth round. As you can see, a conical shape has already started forming. So we will do the first single crochet stitch of the fifth round and mark that with a stitch marker. In the next 3 stitches, we will be doing 1 single crochet in each one of those, and in the following stitch, we will be doing an increase, that is 2 single crochet stitches. We will repeat the pattern, that is 1 single crochet, 1 single crochet, 1 single crochet, 1 single crochet followed by 2 single crochets. Begin the 6th round with 1 single crochet and then mark that with a stitch marker. And then in the next 4 stitches, we will be doing 1 single crochet in each one of those. Next stitch, we will be doing an increase, and we we will repeat this pattern, that is in the next 5 stitches. We will be doing one single crochet in each one of those, followed by 2 single crochet in the next stitch, and repeat. Okay, done. Now we will begin the 7th round. We will do the first single crochet stitch of the 7th round and mark that with a stitch marker. In the next 5 stitches, we will be doing one single crochet in each one of those. And then in the following stitch, we will be doing an increase. So this is the pattern. That is, in the next 6 stitches, we will be doing one single crochet in each one of those, followed by 2 single crochets in the next stitch. We will begin the 8th round. Do the first single crochet stitch of the 8th round and mark that with a stitch marker. And then in the following 6 stitches, we will be doing one single crochet in each one of those. And in the next stitch, we will be doing an increase. And this is the pattern. That is, in the following 7 stitches, we will do one single crochet in each one of those, followed by 2 single crochets in the next stitch, and repeat. We will now begin the 9th round. In the next stitch, we will do one single crochet and mark this first stitch of this 9th round with a stitch marker. And then we will be doing one single crochet in each of the following 7 stitches. And in the next stitch, we will be doing an increase. Repeat this pattern, that is one single crochet in each of the next 8 stitches, followed by 2 single crochets in the next stitch. We will begin the 10th round now. In the next stitch, we will do one single crochet and mark this first stitch of this 10th round with a stitch marker. Then in each of the following stitches, we will be doing one single crochet in each one of those. So this round is a round of one single crochet stitch in each and every stitch of the last round. And we will quickly complete this round. We will now do the 11th and 12th round of one single crochet in each one of those. Okay, so total 12 rounds are done. Now we will just do a slip stitch in the next stitch, followed by a chain 1 and cut the yarn. And the conical portion of the toadstool is done. We will now do the white colored stem portion. So for that, we will just take the inside part out of this cone. We will take a white colored yarn, make a slip knot with it, and insert the hook in it. And then we will just do a slip stitch in the second loop of the single crochet stitches, as I'm showing you. Insert your hook in the second loop of the stitch and just do a slip stitch there, followed by a chain 1 to secure the slip stitch. And in the same stitch, we will be doing one single crochet stitch. Then we will do a decrease in the next 2 stitches, that is, insert your hook in the next stitch, draw the yarn through it, insert your hook in the next stitch and draw the yarn through it. 3 loops in the hook, yarn over and draw the yarn through all the 3 loops, and this is a decrease. We will repeat this pattern, that is, in the next stitch we will do one single crochet stitch, and in the next two stitches we will do a decrease. Just remember, the stitches are to be done in the second loop of the stitches in this round. Okay, and we will repeat this pattern throughout this round. We'll now begin the round 14. We will do one single crochet stitch in the first stitch of the round 13 and mark this first stitch with a stitch marker. Then in the next stitch also we will be doing one single crochet stitch there, and in the next two stitches we will be doing a decrease. We will do the stitches in both the loop of the stitches. So in the next two stitches we will be doing one single crochet in each one of those, and in the next two stitches we will be doing a decrease, and repeat this pattern. Then we will begin the 15th round with one single crochet stitch. Mark the stitch with a stitch marker. Then in the next two stitches we will be doing a decrease. In the next stitch we will be doing one single crochet, and in the next two stitches we will be doing a decrease, and we will repeat this pattern. At this moment we will fill up our cone portion with the fiber fills. Give it a conical shape with your hands. Okay, in this manner. And now we will just begin the round 16. So in this round 16 we will be doing one single crochet stitch in each of the stitches of the last round. So do the first single crochet stitch and mark that with a stitch marker, and then we will continue doing one single crochet stitch in each of the stitches of the last round. In this manner we will complete this round quickly, and we will do four more such round. We will now begin the round 21. So we will do one single crochet stitch in the next stitch of the previous round. Mark this first stitch of round 21 with a stitch marker. Then in the following stitch we will be doing an increase. Then in the next stitch we will be doing one single crochet stitch followed by an increase in the next stitch, and then we will repeat this pattern throughout this round. Now we will start closing the round, but before that fill up the remaining portion of the mushroom with some fiber fill and give it a proper shape using your hand. We will start doing the decreasing stitches. So in the next two stitches we will be doing a decrease in this manner. In the next two stitches again we will be doing a decrease. And we will repeat this pattern till the stem closes. Okay. And when the stem has closed up, we will just complete it by doing a slip stitch in this manner, followed by chain one, and then we will just cut the yarn. Pull the loop and we will weave in the loose end. So our toadstool pattern is now completed. Weave in the loose end, give it a proper shape with your hand. And at the end, we will just embroider small white spots on the top portion of the toadstool in this manner. It's really easy. In this manner, we will embroider small polka dots like shapes on the top portion of the toadstool. At the end, we will just tie a knot, cut the yarn, and weave in the loose end. So with this, my tutorial comes to an end. I hope it was easy to follow. And for making a keychain out of it, just tie a loop around it and hang the keychain. I hope you like this tutorial, and if you like this tutorial, then please hit the like button, comment in the comment section for any queries. Also mention if you want to see any other kind of videos. I will love to make those for you. And please subscribe to my channel. And thank you and have a great day.